Good afternoon. So we have successfully discussed about the animal kingdom introduction, levels of classification, and we also completed in botany part that the living world, diversity in the living world. So the first animal kingdom in non-chordates is porifera. Okay. So poriferans are also called as pore-bearing animals. So the poriferans are the animals, they have pores. Upon the body of the poriferans, there are many, many pores. Okay. So due to these pores only, they are called as what? Poriferans. So poriferans are the animals which are non-chordates and they have pores all over their body. So due to that region only, they are named as porifera. So poriferans are nothing but they are pore-bearing animals. Now you know very well, these are lowest multicellular animals because unicellular animals are their single cell. Then we have multicellular animals. So multicellular animals will start with the porifera only. So we are saying that lowest multicellular animals. These are the lowest multicellular animals, no doubt. Okay. Now, they are commonly called as sponges. They are commonly called as what? Sponges. So they are nicknamed, they are called as what? Sponges. Okay, so these are the lowest multicellular animals.
Sponges. Okay, so these are the
multicellular animals and they are commonly called as what? They are commonly called as sponges. Okay. Now the most important feature of these animals is that they are at cellular level. This is a notable point. Cellular level of organization. So they do not have the tissues. So the body is made up of only cells. There is no division of labor. It means body do not have tissues. So all the cells will be different types of cells will be present in the poriferan animals. So we are seeing them at cellular level. Okay, so these are the lowest multicellular animals. They are commonly called as sponges. They are at cellular level. Okay, so and few sponges will live in marine water. Marine water means sea water. Okay. So maximum all the sponges are aquatic in nature, means they need water. Like the fish is aquatic animal. So sponges are also aquatic in nature. Some sponges will live in fresh water and some sponges will live in marine water. So all sponges are aquatic. All sponges are aquatic. It means they live in water. Right, mostly marine. So most of the sponges are marine, means they live in marine water. Few are fresh water. Few are fresh water. Some of the sponges will live in fresh water. Okay, so this is one important point of the sponges, that all the sponges are aquatic in nature, mostly marine, but few sponges live in fresh water. Okay. So when you go for the animal kingdom, no, animal kingdom will start with the in animal kingdom what we have non-chordates, we have hemichordates, we have chordates. In non-chordates, what are there? In non-chordates, starts with the porifera, ends with the echinodermata, right? So now what we are discussing, the first phylum of animal kingdom, that is porifera. They are lowest multicellular animals, no doubt. They are lowest multicellular animals. They are at cellular level. It means the body do not contain any tissues. They are pore-bearing animals. All over the body, they have pores. They are commonly called as sponges. They are aquatic in nature. Most of the sponges are living in the marine water. Few sponges will live in the fresh water. Okay. Now, they have another unique feature that most of the sponges are asymmetrical. We have studied about already the symmetry. Most of the sponges are asymmetrical, but some sponges will exhibit radial symmetry. Okay, so out of 100, 70% of the sponges are asymmetrical in nature, but few sponges are having radial symmetry. Now these sponges are sessile and sedentary. This is an important word. Sponges are sessile and sedentary. Sessile means they are attached at one place. They are fixed at one place. So generally sponges are fixed to the rocks and they will be fixed lifelong. They will be fixed lifelong. So this nature is known as what? Sessile. Sessile means fixed at one place. Sedentary. Sedentary is an important word. Sedentary means what? They do not show much physical activity. So we show a physical activity. We will do running. We will do jumping. We will fold our hands. We will sit. We will jump. Many animals, if you see, they do a physical activity. But our sponges are sessile, means they are fixed at one place. Sedentary, they do not show much physical activity. Okay, that is the nature of the sponges. Okay, but larva of the sponges will show physical activity. So adult sponges are sessile and sedentary, but the larval form of the sponges is motile. It is able to move. Sponges do not move. They are fixed at one place. If an organism is fixed at one place, it is called sessile organism. If an organism do not show a physical activity, we say it as a sedentary organism. So adult sponges are sessile and sedentary, whereas the larva is there, it is motile. Okay, you take this note quickly.
Sir.
Haan beta.
Can you write that spelling of sessile and sedentary?
Yeah, I will write that. I will write all the points. I will write. Okay. Now.
Sir, sponges are not sponges are not microscopic, no?
No, they are not microscopic. We can see them. So, what I am saying, adult sponges are sessile and sedentary. Sessile means what? Fixed at one place. Generally, our sponges are fixed to rocks. They are attached to the rocks. Sedentary. Little physical activity or no physical activity. It means sponges will not show any movement. Okay. So adult sponges are sessile and sedentary. But larva is motile. From the sponges, when the sponges reproduce, they will not form directly the animal, but they will show some larval stage, which is there, and the larva will undergo some development. Suppose this is a sponge. When it is reproducing, it will not form directly the sponge. Instead, it will form a larval stage. This larval stage will grow and develop into the adult form. So larva is an intermediate between two adults. Okay. So some of the animals will exhibit larval stages. Insects also exhibit larval stages. Silkworm, a good example, which exhibits many larval stages. Cockroach also exhibits larval stages. Human beings do not exhibit larval stages. So there are some animals which exhibit the larval stage. So poriferans are also the animals which will not develop, which will not reproduce directly. Sponge giving rise to sponge is a direct reproduction. Instead, they will form a larva. Larva will undergo some changes, and it will be converted into adult form. That process we say biologically as metamorphosis. So metamorphosis is the conversion of the larva to the adult form. So many animals, generally many lower animals will show larval stages. Higher animals do not generally show larval stages. Okay. So this larva of our sponge is motile. It will be moving. But the adult sponge is sessile and sedentary, fixed at one place, and it is showing little physical activity. Okay, that is the meaning here. This point, I hope, sessile sedentary point is technically clear to you. Now, another important feature of sponges is what? Sponges are asymmetrical. Most of the sponges are asymmetrical. But some sponges exhibit radial symmetry. So you have to remember the name, only one name of the sponge which is exhibiting radial symmetry. There is one sponge known as Leucosonia. Leucosonia. This is the sponge, an example of a sponge which exhibits radial symmetry. Okay, out of 100 sponges, near about 80 to 90% of sponges are asymmetrical. There are few exceptions. There are some few exceptional cases which exhibit radial symmetry. So Leucosonia is an example of a sponge which exhibits radial symmetry. Apart from this, there may be many examples, but you have to remember this one example. Leucosonia is a sponge which exhibits the radial symmetry, but maximum sponges are asymmetric in nature. They cannot be divided into two equal parts. Okay. Now, the most unique feature of sponges is sponges have water vascular system. This is the most unique feature of the sponges, that sponges is having water vascular system, which is called as water transport system, which is also called as canal system. Which is also called as what? Canal system. So sponges ka ye bahut important property hai, ek unique feature hai ki sponges mein canal system hota hai. Right? Ab hume ye dekhna hai ki ye canal system kya hai. Right? Now, I've already said you कि जो जितने भी sponges हैं उनके body के ऊपर बहुत सारे pores होते हैं. Okay? अगर ये sponge है, for example, तो sponge के body के ऊपर बहुत सारे pores हैं. Let us think these are the minute microscopic pores are there on the body of the sponge. These pores are called as ostia. Remember the word ostia, right? So sponges are having a pores which is called as what? Ostia. And there is one large pore anywhere in the body which is called osculum, right? So sponges ke body ke pure pores hain. ये पोर्स को कहा जाता है ओस्टिया. और एक ओस्टिया बड़ा होता है, सबसे बड़ा, उसको ही कहा जाता है ओस्कुलम. क्लियर? सो बॉडी ऑफ द स्पॉन्जेस आर हैविंग मेनी पोर्स. पोर्स ऑफ द स्पॉन्जेस आर कॉल्ड ओस्टिया एंड दे हैव वन लार्ज पोर व्हिच इज नोन एज व्हाट? ओस्कुलम. अब ये कैनल सिस्टम क्या है, इसको हम थोड़ा डिटेलली देखेंगे कि स्पॉन्जेस में वॉटर वास्कुलर सिस्टम है, वॉटर ट्रांसपोर्ट सिस्टम है और ये कैनल सिस्टम है. तो ये कैनल सिस्टम को समझने के लिए हमें पहले स्पॉन्ज की बॉडी को समझना जरूरी है. ओके, सो आई रिपीट दिस टू स्टेटमेंट्स. जितने भी स्पॉन्जेस है वो एसिमेट्रिकल हैं. कुछ स्पॉन्जेस रेडियल सिमेट्री को एक्सिबिट करते हैं, जैसा Leucosonia एग्जांपल है. और स्पॉन्जेस का एक खासियत है, एक स्पेशलिटी है, एक यूनिक फीचर है कि उनमें वॉटर ट्रांसपोर्ट सिस्टम होता है, उनमें कैनल सिस्टम होता है. अभी ये कैनल सिस्टम क्या है, इसको जानने के लिए थोड़ा स्पॉन्ज के बॉडी को टेक्निकली बायोलॉजिकली एक बार हम देखेंगे, फिर उसके बाद कैनल सिस्टम में आपको बताऊंगा. ये दो पॉइंट्स आपके क्लियर है?
यस सर.
राइट. अब बॉडी का कैनल सिस्टम क्या है देखेंगे. तो अभी जो स्पॉन्जेस एसिरोमेट्स हैं, इनमें कोई सीलोम विलोम नहीं है, बट इनका जो बॉडी वॉल है, हमें मालूम है कि व्हाट इज सीलोम. इफ एनीबॉडी आस्क यू, सीलोम इज नथिंग बट स्पेस बिटवीन द बॉडी वॉल एंड एलिमेंटरी कैनल, दैट इज गट, वी से इट एज सीलोम. बट स्पॉन्जेस आर एसिमेट्रिक एसिलोमेट्स, दे डू नॉट हैव द सीलोम. राइट. नाउ व्हेन यू टेक द बॉडी वॉल ऑफ द स्पॉन्जेस, द बॉडी वॉल ऑफ द स्पॉन्जेस इज बाइलेयर्ड, इट इज हैविंग टू लेयर्स. व्हेन बॉडी वॉल इज हैविंग टू लेयर्स, वी से डिप्लोब्लास्टिक एनिमल. व्हेन द बॉडी वॉल हैज थ्री लेयर्स, थ्री डर्म लेयर्स, वी से डिप्लोब्लास्टिक एनिमल्स. आर when cells of the animal are arranged in three layers, first layer, second layer, third layer, triploblastic. When cells of the animal are arranged in two layers, diploblastic. When cells of the animal are arranged in one layer, there is no animal like this. In the entire world, there is no animal like this. Animal may be diplo, animal may be triplo, but our sponges are diploblastic animal. Cells of this sponge are arranged in two layers. The body wall is having two layers, outer layer, inner layer, राइट। तो जो स्पॉन्ज का बॉडी वॉल है उसमें दो लेयर है, आउटर लेयर है और इनर लेयर है। आउटर लेयर को कहा जाता है पिनाकोडर्म। आउटर लेयर का नाम क्या है? पिनाकोडर्म, राइट। स्पॉन्जेस का जो आउटर लेयर है उसको कहा जाता है पिनाकोडर्म, और स्पॉन्जेस का जो इनर लेयर है उसको कहा जाता है कोयनोडर्म। स्पॉन्सर, आई होप इट्स वेरी क्रिस्टल क्लियर फॉर यू। तो स्पॉन्जेस का जो बॉडी वॉल है वो दो लेयर्स में बटा हुआ है। एक आउटर लेयर है जिसका नाम है पिनाकोडर्म, और एक इनर लेयर है जिसको हम बोलते हैं कोयनोडर्म, राइट। सो स्पॉन्जेस की बॉडी वॉल ऐसा है। नाउ ये जो पिनाकोडर्म है कुछ स्पेशल सेल्स से बना हुआ है। पिनाकोडर्म में कुछ पिनाकोडर्म इज मेड अप ऑफ सेल्स नोन एज पिनाकोसाइट्स। रिमेम्बर द नेम, पिनाकोडर्म इज मेड अप ऑफ सेल्स विच आर नोन एज पिनाकोसाइट्स। कोयनोडर्म इज मेड अप ऑफ सेल्स विच आर नोन एज कोयनोसाइट्स, विच आर नोन एज कोयनोसाइट्स। कोयनोसाइट्स आर आल्सो नोन एज पोलर सेल्स। Coenocytes are also known as what? Polar cells. Generally, the cells will be like this way, having one polar-like structure and some hair-like structures. Okay? So, it's very clear कि sponges का जो body wall है, उसमें दो layer है, outer वाला pinacoderm, inner वाला coenoderm. Pinacoderm pinacocyte cells से बना हुआ है, coenoderm coenocyte से बना हुआ है. Coenocytes are also called as what? Polar cells. Right? अब और एक पॉइंट ये है कि ये जो पिनाकोडर्म और कोयनोडर्म है, आउटर और इनर, इनके बीच में एक होता है, राइट, एक बीच में एक लेयर होता है जो नॉन सेलुलर है, नॉन लिविंग है, जेलेटिनस है। जेलेटिनस मींस लाइक द जेल, क्लोज अप जेल, राइट। So in between pinacoderm and coenoderm there is non-cellular, non-living gelatinous layer. इस layer को कहा जाता है gelatinous layer called mesenchyme. Remember the name mesenchyme, right? So the body wall of the sponges is having two layers: outer pinacoderm, inner coenoderm. Pinacoderm is made up of pinacocytes. Coenoderm is made up of coenocytes. Coenocytes are also called as polar cells. In between them, there is non-cellular, non-living gelatinous layer which is known as mesenchyme. Which is known as what? Mesenchyme. याद होगा? ये point पूरा clear है?
Sir,
this point is clear.
Sir, what is that layer made up of?
Which layer?
The between layer.
It is made up of mesenchyme, which is gelatinous in nature, like the gel.
Okay.
Okay. Right. Now. Let us think that this is our sponge. Right? This is our sponge. Now, this is a body wall. This is having two layers. I am drawing like this where two layers. First layer, uske niche second layer. First layer, uske niche second layer. Right. So first layer is what? First layer is our pinacoderm. What is second layer? Second layer is coenoderm. In between there is a gelatinous tissue. I am using black color for convenience. In between there is one gelatinous tissue like the gel. which is nothing but which is called as mesenchyme. How is mesenchyme? Mesenchyme is non-living. Mesenchyme is gelatinous. Mesenchyme is non-cellular. Clear? So mesenchyme कैसा है? Mesenchyme कोई cell से बना हुआ नहीं है, सिर्फ एक चिकना substance है दोनों के दो layers के बीच में, जिसे हम बोलते हैं mesenchyme. तो mesenchyme जो है non-living है. Non-living क्यों है? क्योंकि उसमें cells नहीं है. Right? एक gel-like substance is there. इस mesenchyme में बहुत सारे cells float करते रहते हैं. तो ये जो mesenchyme है उनमें बहुत प्रकार के different different types of cells are floating. Mesenchyme is not made up of cells, but in the mesenchyme some cells are floating or some cells are scattered. Okay? So ये जो है अपना sponges का structure, और ये जो बीच में जो sponges के body में जो space होता है उसे कहा जाता है spongocoel. Clear? तो स्पॉन्जेस के बॉडी में जो स्पेस है उसको ही हम बोलते हैं स्पॉन्जोसील. स्पॉन्जोसील को पैरागैस्ट्रिक कैविटी भी कहा जाता है. स्पॉन्जोसील इज नोन एज व्हाट? पैरागैस्ट्रिक कैविटी. इनसाइड द स्पॉन्जेस देयर इज अ बॉडी कैविटी, दिस बॉडी कैविटी. इनसाइड द स्पॉन्जेस देयर इज अ स्पेस व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एज स्पॉन्जोसील. स्पॉन्जोसील इज आल्सो नोन एज पैरागैस्ट्रिक कैविटी. स्पॉन्जोसील इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज व्हाट? पैरागैस्ट्रिक कैविटी. राइट? Now, मान लो फॉर एग्जाम्पल ये है अपना कोयनोडर्म. थोड़ा भी इसको उतार के देखेंगे थोड़ा. ये है मान लो फॉर एग्जाम्पल आउटर वाला लेयर इनर कोडर्म. क्लियर? ग्रीन से उतार रहा हूं. ये अपना पिनाकोडर्म है आउटर वाला लेयर. उसके नीचे क्या रहेगा? कोयनोडर्म जो कॉलर सेल से बना हुआ है. कॉलर सेल्स कुछ ऐसे होते हैं, इसको कॉलर होता है. ओके, लाइक दिस वे कॉलर सेल्स विल बी देयर हैविंग द फ्लैजेला. ओके, मान लो ये अपने कॉलर सेल्स हैं. दिस आर द कॉलर सेल्स रफली आई एम ड्रॉइंग. ओके, दे हैव द फ्लैजेला. How the flagella like this. Now in between this there is one space which is filled with dead non-living tissue, which the tissue name is what? Mesenchyme. So I am drawing the mesenchyme here. Which is gelatinous in nature. This is all the mesenchyme. Clear understanding? Now inside this mesenchyme it contains some cells. Mesenchyme में बहुत सारे cells होते हैं. वो cells क्या है? Amoebocytes. कुछ cells है Arachnocytes. These are some cells. Okay, which are present in the mesenchyme. Now, it also have some cells known as sporocytes. These are also the cells which are having, which are present in the mesenchyme. So you know very well, amoebocytes are irregular shape. इनका shape कैसा होता है? Irregular होता है, जैसा कि amoeba होता है. तो arachnocytes जो हैं, याद रखो, arachnocytes जो हैं, totipotent cells हैं. ओके, ये एराकियोसाइट्स जो हैं रीजनरेशन में हेल्प करते हैं. सो स्पॉन्जेस विल शो रीजनरेशन. इफ द बॉडी पार्ट इज कट इट विल अगेन डेवलप इनटू न्यू बॉडी पार्ट, दैट इज नोन एज व्हाट? रीजनरेशन. सो इन द स्पॉन्जेस देयर आर सम स्पेशल सेल्स नोन एज एराकियोसाइट्स. विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस एराकियोसाइट्स ओनली स्पॉन्जेस आर एबल टू डू रीजनरेशन. दिस स्पोरोसाइट्स आर मॉडिफाइड पिनाकोसाइट्स. You remember this information that the sporocytes are what? Modified, what you can say? Pinacocytes. Inside the mesenchyme, there are some spicules. Right? सो मीजेनकाइम में स्पिक्यूल्स भी होते हैं. सो व्हाट आर स्पिक्यूल्स मींस दीस आर द स्केलेटन एलिमेंट्स लाइक अवर बॉडी इज देयर. अवर बॉडी स्केलेटन इज मेड अप ऑफ बोन्स. इन द स्पॉन्जेस देर आर सम स्ट्रक्चर्स विच आर नोन एज स्पिक्यूल्स. दे फॉर्म द स्केलेटन सिस्टम ऑफ द स्पॉन्जेस बट एक्चुअली इन द स्पॉन्जेस देर इज नो वेल डेवलप्ड स्केलेटन सिस्टम बट देर आर सम स्ट्रक्चर्स नोन एज स्पिक्यूल्स विच आर मेड अप ऑफ कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट. They are working as skeleton in the sponges. So some spicules are also distributed in the mesenchyme of the sponges. Clear?
So what is spicules made up of?
Calcium carbonate. CaCO3.
Sir?
Huh.
What is the other name for spongocele?
Other name of?
Spongocele.
Paragastric cavity. यहां तक पॉइंट्स पूरे क्लियर हैं?
Yes, sir.
किसी को कुछ कंफ्यूजन है?
No, sir.
Anybody have any confusion? You can ask. Okay. Now, when you go for the water vascular system or canal system of the sponges, so the water will be coming, it is entering ostia, the pores, then all the water will enter into the body cavity, which is known as spongocele. And from osculum, the water will move out. This is the route map of the water. So water will enter into the body with the ostia. It will enter into the spongocele and it will go out through osculum. This is in. Through osculum, water will move out of the body. This is a canal system of the sponges, right? With the help of this canal system only, respiratory exchange. What is the function of canal system? It is helping in exchange of gases, O2 in, CO2 out, removal of waste materials. Canal system also helps in exchange of gases, removal of the waste materials. Canal system also helps in collection of food. Why? Because all the water which is coming and entering into the body of the sponges may contain some food particles also, some small aquatic marine animals or plants also. So the canal system has three four important functions: respiratory exchange, the removal of the waste, and collection of the food material. So these are all the functions of what? The canal system of the sponges. Right?
Yes, sir.
Now, spongocele, I have said you, it is also called as what? Paragastric cavity. For your information, I am writing paragastric cavity. Now, another thing is that the body of sponges is supported by, the body of the sponges is supported by skeleton made of spicules. These are some structures and fibers which are known as spongin fibers. So the body of the sponges will have some structures like these structures, which are known as spicules, and some fibers, which are known as spongin fibers. Generally, the spicules are made up of calcium carbonate. These are made up of calcium carbonate, silicon dioxide, many, many chemicals they are made up of. We are not interested with the chemical composition. So you remember that the body of the sponges is supported by skeleton. body of the human beings is supported by skeleton. Human beings skeleton is made up of bones and cartilages. Body of the sponges is made up of skeleton. It is supported by spicules and spongin fibers. Spicules are some little microscopic bone-like structures. Fibers are thread-like structures which will give mechanical support to the sponges, right? So we can say that sponges also exhibit a primitive skeleton system made up of spicules and spongin fibers. Now these spicules and spongin fibers are produced by some special cells, produced by some cells which are known as scleroblast cells. Which are known as what? Scleroblast cells. Right? Now sponges excretory waste, in the sponges excretory waste material is ammonia. In sponges excretory waste material is what? Ammonia. Okay, different animals will excrete different chemicals. Some excrete ammonia, some excrete uric acid, some excrete urea. Okay, so if any organism excretes ammonia, we say ammonotelic animal. Urea, ureotelic. Uric acid, uricotelic. Like that way we have classification based upon the excretion. So here you have to remember that sponges excretory material mainly contains ammonia chemical. Okay, now in the sponges there is no nervous system. We can say that nervous system is absent. Okay, so due to the absence of nervous system, there are cells which are known as pinacocytes. I've already said you, these pinacocytes will respond to external stimuli. There is no brain, no nerves, nervous system is totally absent, but they are giving response. They are conscious because of pinacocyte cells. So pinacocyte cells do the function of nervous system. So pinacocyte cells will respond to external stimuli. Ye point clear hai?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now our sponges, when you go for nutrition of sponges, nutrition is holozoic. It means they eat solid food materials. Human beings are also holozoic. We eat solid food. Insects eat liquid foods. They are saprozoic. That is a different. So sponges are holozoic. Nutrition is holozoic. Digestion is intracellular. It means digestion occurs inside the cell. They do not have elementary canal, stomach, small intestine, like that. Inside the cells only the digestion is occurring. Digestion is intracellular, occurs in food vacuole. Okay, so inside the cell there is one vacuole which is known as food vacuole. Inside this food vacuole only digestion will occur. Generally vacuoles are present in plants, but animals also contain vacuole which are called as food vacuole. Some animals have contractile vacuole, some animals have food vacuoles. So food vacuoles will help in digestion. Okay, so nutrition is holozoic, intracellular, occurs in food vacuole of pyomyocyte cell. Okay, pyomyocyte, the polar cell. Inside this polar cell, there is a food vacuole. Inside this food vacuole, digestion is going to happen. So that is the reason we are saying digestion as intracellular, inside the cell, intracellular. Okay, outside the cell, extracellular. Nervous system is absent. There is no nervous system in our sponges. But pinacocytes respond to external stimuli. So pinacocytes will be there inside the sponge body. So these pinacocytes will be responding to the external stimuli. Now, last point, important point is all sponges are hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite means bisexual. Means we cannot have a male sponge and a female sponge. We have bisexual sponges. It means male reproductive organs, female reproductive organs, when they are present in the same animal, we say it as a bisexual animal. So bisexual word is generally used for plants. In case of animal, if an animal is bisexual, we use a biological word, hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite means bisexual. Clear?
So herma.
I will write that point.
Okay, sir.
After this point, that point only I am going to write. Now this is an important point. All sponges are hermaphrodite. But you must not use the word bisexual. Hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite means bisexual, okay? But cross-fertilization takes place. Now, what is cross-fertilization? Suppose let us think that this is a male, this is a sponge, for example. This is a male sex organ M, this is a female sex organ F. When male and female sex organs are present in the same animal, we say hermaphrodite. Now, the male produces sperms. Sperms of the male may enter into the female. This is self-fertilization. But in the sponges, self-fertilization will never occur. Always cross-fertilization will occur. Like in the animal, in the plants, we say self-pollination, cross-pollination. So in the animals, self-fertilization, cross-fertilization. Okay? So in the sponges, cross-fertilization takes place. Fertilization is internal. What is the meaning of internal fertilization? Any idea?
A fusion takes place inside the body.
Absolutely correct. So yes. When the fertilization takes place inside the body, we say internal fertilization. If it takes place outside, we say it as external fertilization. So in the sponges, fertilization is internal, right? Now, in the sponges, asexual reproduction also occurs. Asexual reproduction generally occurs by budding or fragmentation. Budding or fragmentation is the method of asexual reproduction in sponges. So asexual reproduction generally takes place by budding. Or it may take place by fragmentation. Okay.
Or by regeneration also, no, sir.
Yeah, by regeneration also. But most commonly budding and fragmentation. Okay. Development is indirect. Indirect means what? There is a larval stage. Direct means what? There is no larval stage. Okay. So development is indirect का मतलब क्या हुआ कि sponges directly develop नहीं होते हैं, पहले larva बनना पड़ता है, larva को फिर change होते 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 adult बनना पड़ता है, okay? So इनमें larval stages के नाम याद रखना है, amphiblastula, ये larva का नाम है, amphiblastula larva, you can see this larva in sponge skypha. Skypha is a sponge in which you can see amphiblastula larva. And there is another larval stage known as parenchyma. This parenchyma larva you can see in Leucocelonia. Okay, remember the larval stages. So sponges mein do hi larval stages hain. Ya to amphiblastula larva ho sakta. Amphiblastula larva bahut sare sponges mein hota hai. Bahut sare sponges mein ka ek example maine likha. Skypa. पैरेन्काइमा लार्वा भी होता है, पैरेन्काइमा लार्वा का एक एग्जांपल है ल्यूकोसोलोनिया। ओके, सो डेवलपमेंट इज इनडायरेक्ट का मतलब क्या हुआ कि स्पॉन्जेस में रिप्रोडक्शन होने के बाद लार्वा बनेगा, लार्वा फिर चेंजेस होते होते अडल्ट बनेगा। चेंजिंग ऑफ लार्वा टू अडल्ट दैट प्रोसेस वी से इट एज मेटामॉर्फोसिस, राइट। सो मेटामॉर्फोसिस इज द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द लार्वा इनटू द अडल्ट, दैट प्रोसेस इज नोन एज व्हाट, मेटामॉर्फोसिस। दिस पॉइंट इज क्लियर
सर?
हाँ श्रावणी।
सर व्हाट इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन एम्फीब्लास्टुला लार्वा एंड पैरेन्काइमा लार्वा?
Only the structural difference will be there. Okay, so amphiblastula larva is structurally different from parenchyma. Okay, but both the larvas are motile, means they have the ability to move. But adults are non-motile. Right. Now. You have to remember the functions of cells also. Now generally, in sponges, there are some cells known as the, many types of cells are there, but the cells which are mentioned, that only I am saying you, there are some cells known as cytosites, they store food. Right? There are some cells known as arachiocytes. Arachiocytes help in regeneration, they also produce gametes, male gamete, female gamete. They also help in the regeneration, right? This you have to remember the information. I am writing at one place. So arachiocytes will produce gametes. They are also helping in regeneration. Okay. Again, scleroblast. What they will do? They will produce spicules and spongin fibers. Okay, that is scleroblast. Choanocytes. Generally, choanocytes help in feeding and ensures flow of water. Because water is always entering into the body of the sponges. The quantity of the water is controlled by choanocyte cells only. You remember this much information at one place. Okay, cytosolites will store food. Arachiocytes will produce gametes and help in regeneration. Scleroblast will produce spicules and spongin fibers. Choanocytes will help in feeding. And inside the choanocytes food vacuole only, digestion is going to take place. Right? And they are also responsible for ensuring the flow of water. Pinococytes will respond to stimuli. Okay, pinococytes will respond to stimuli. Clear these points? Clear to you? Now, three examples of the sponges from NCERT and module. There are thousands of examples of sponges, but the mentioned examples of the sponges, examples, one sponge is Cycon. One sponge name is Cycon. Another sponge name is Spongilla. Another sponge name is Euspongia. Clear? This Cycon is commonly called as Taipa. This Spongilla is called freshwater sponge. It lives in fresh water. Okay. This Euspongia is called as bath sponge. These are NCERT examples and module examples. Okay, you remember these examples.
Sir.
सर
अमित
सर हमें एक ही नाम याद रखना है, जैसे काइफा या तो साइकॉन, दोनों में से कोई एक ही ना।
मित वंस यू रिपीट लिटिल, थोड़ा वॉइस स्लो आ रहा था, एक बार और एक बार रिपीट करो।
सर वो हम लोग को एक ही नाम याद रखना है ना, साइकॉन या तो स्काइफा।
नहीं, दो नाम याद रखना है, क्योंकि कभी कभार व्हाट विल हैपन मींस इन जनरल इन क्वेश्चंस व्हाट यू विल डू, यू विल गिव साइकॉन स्पॉन्जिला यू स्पॉन्ज एट वन प्लेस, यू विल आस्क यू टू मैच विद देयर नेम्स। सो साइकॉन इज कॉमनली कॉल्ड स्काइपा, स्पॉन्जिला इज sometimes called fresh water sponge, it is a local name, this is the scientific name means this is the biological name is cycan, we say it as skypa, so you have to remember both, exam mein kuch bhi puch sakta, he will ask you dash is the bath, identify the bath sponge from the given, he will give you four examples, cycan, spongilla, eu spongia something, then he will ask you identify bath sponge, so anything is possible, so everything you have to remember, okay. Right. Now, porifera. Now, when you go for poriferans, they are commonly called sponges. Pore bearing animals. Okay. Pinacoderm, Choanoderm. Right. Diploblastic. Asymmetric. Exception, some are radial. Right. I am writing all the points in a shortcut way. इनके कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर कैनल सिस्टम, स्पॉन्जेस में कैनल सिस्टम होता है, राइट, कैनल सिस्टम इज द मोस्ट यूनिक फीचर ऑफ आवर स्पॉन्जेस, स्केलेटन सिस्टम भी होता है, जो स्पीक्यूल्स और स्पॉन्जिन फाइबर से बना हुआ है, बाइसेक्सुअल है, जितने भी स्पॉन्जेस है बाइसेक्सुअल है, लार्वल स्टेज होता है, लार्वल स्टेज मतलब लार्वा का नाम याद रखना है, नर्वस सिस्टम एब्सेंट है, राइट, न्यूट्रिशन होलोजॉइक है, इंट्रासेलुलर डाइजेशन, राइट, तीन एग्जांपल्स, यस एस ई स्पॉन्जिला यू स्पॉन्जिया एस एस सी, अंडरस्टूड, दिस इज द टोटल स्टोरी व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड, राइट, आई रिपीट, फाइलम पोरिफेरा इंक्लूड्स पोर बियरिंग एनिमल्स, दिस इंक्लूड्स लोवेस्ट मल्टीसेलुलर एनिमल्स कॉमनली कॉल्ड स्पॉन्जेस, दे आर एट सेलुलर लेवल, मोस्टली एक्वाटिक, all sponges are aquatic, mostly marine, few are fresh water, sponges are asymmetrical, some exhibit radial symmetry, leucocelonia, sponges are sessile sedentary, but larva is motile, they have water canal system, ostia spongocoelosculum, water vascular system has three functions, respiratory exchange, removal of the waste, collection of the food, body wall, outer pinacoderm, inner choanoderm, in between mesenchyme, pinacoderm is made up of pinacocytes, choanoderm is made up of choanocytes, choanocytes are also called as collar cells, collar cells help in feeding, they also ensure flow of water, inside the food vacuole of the collar cell only digestion will occur, right, nutrition is holozoic, digestion is intracellular, occurs in the food vacuole of choanocytes, nervous system absent, pinacocytes respond to external stimuli, all sponges are bisexual, hermaphrodite, but cross fertilization takes place, fertilization internal, gametes are produced by arachiocytes, asexual reproduction by budding and fragmentation, regeneration, development indirect, amphiblastula larva, parenchyma larva, special cells, schizocytes, special cells store the food, arachiocytes, regenerating cells, totipotent cells. They help in the formation of gametes. Scleroblast cells. They produce spongin fibers and spicules. Pinacocytes respond to external stimuli. These are the some of the special cells. Porocytes, modified pinacocytes are called porocytes. Okay. Now you can ask if you have any confusion. Any doubt, any question, any confusion, you can raise. Nothing confusion?
No, sir.
Right. Any question from anybody? Right. So tomorrow our class will be on as usual time only. As today due to vaccination, some problem came to me. So I have to visit once again the doctor. On Saturday I have took the vaccine. That is the reason I was unable to take the class. So from tomorrow our time will be normal as usual time only. Okay. So tomorrow we'll start biological classification, second lesson of the botany. So in the animal kingdom, many we have completed much more. We are more advanced than the micro schedule. So in botany also, we are more advanced than the micro schedule. These are the simple topics. We do not need much explanation. As you are seeing only the points, by reading the points only you can understand. Here your memory, you must remember all the examples. So for that, you have to do the written practice. Okay. So if you do the written practice only, you can remember the examples. Wherever there is a technique, there is a trick, definitely I will say you wherever the trick comes. But everything in tricky way, it is not possible. So somewhere we have to use the memory, somewhere we have to use the trick. So like that way. So this is the lesson which you have to do written practice for examples, because examples will be asked in the MCQs. So only by written practice only you can remember them. Okay. Any question from anybody?